So what you're going to need is a silhouette clip, or a clip in which the subject is a lot darker than the background, and essentially a space background element. Rocketstock.com offers this absolutely beautiful collection of 4K Nebula background. It's non-computer generated, and more importantly, it's completely free. Links will be included in the description box down below, so definitely check that out. Back to the tutorial, let's start off by dragging your nebula or space background and place it right underneath your original clip. Bring out the effects browser, go down to the search bar and then type in Luma Kia. Drag that and then drop it onto your top clip. Select the top clip, head over to the video inspector. In the Luma tool, go ahead and key out the nebula from the white background, or in this case it's the sky, by pulling this top handle to the left or until it becomes transparent. Key out the white area inside the nebula by pulling this lower left handle to the right. To adjust the softness of the edges, go ahead and use the Luma roll-off control slide. You could also further fine-tune your key by clicking the matte tools to reveal the controls. Use fill holes tool for unwanted holes in the interior of the key. You could also experiment with the level's grayscale gradient and adjust how translucent or solid you want the key areas to be. To get rid of the sharp white lines or edges, simply use the shrink, expand, and the soften slider. Go ahead and tweak it until you're happy with the result. And here's the result! And for those of you, if anyone, is wondering how I did this, it's actually really simple. The first thing you want to do is expand the workspace by pressing Command and then the plus sign on your keyboard. Find a place you wish the flickering in effect to begin. Next, bring out the blade tool by pressing the letter B. Slice this bottom nebula clip. Go forward one frame by pressing the right arrow key and then slice it once again. Repeat this for another 3 to 4 frames. Bring back the select tool by pressing the letter A. Select this first portion of the bottom nebula clip and then disable it by pressing the letter V. Do the same thing to this mid frame and the last frame. Now you should have something that looks like this. And for this Luma fading in effect, it's actually also pretty simple. The first thing you're gonna do is select this bottom nebula clip, bring out the effects browser, go down to the search bar and then type in Luma Kia once again. Double click on that or drag and drop it onto your nebula clip. Make sure you're at the beginning of the clip, hit over to the video inspector. In the Luma control, drag this bottom left handle all the way to the bottom right. Add a keyframe to it by clicking this diamond icon. Go back to your timeline and find a place you wish the Luma fading in effect to end. Head over to the video inspector. In the Luma control, pull back the lower and one of your upper handle all the way to the left, just like this. And that's it. Here's the result. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you find this weird effect somewhat useful or interesting maybe. Anyways, if you did enjoy it, please leave it a like and also subscribe for more short Final Cut Pro tutorials like this one. Good luck with your project, get weird and wild with it, and I'll see you next week. Bye bye.